Well, aside from modeling, there are a great number of uses for symmetry when it comes to duplicating parts. So you can see in this case, looking at the grid, I have a landing gear part here set over to one side, and specifically we're looking at it from the front. So this part I have here would be the left landing gear strut, and as part of the process, what I want to do is mirror this whole assembly over to the other side, so I have a set of left-right landing gear. So there's something specific I want to point out about this part, and that is, right now all the polygons are in one mesh item. So this isn't really suitable for rigging as it stands, because I just saved it as a mesh preset and not an assembly of some sort. There's nothing wrong with that. If you build a whimsical object and you want to just put together a quick render that shows some parts like this, you could use your preset library to make that go a lot faster. And so if we have our part here and it's just fine, then we can do the usual thing, go to Action Center Origin, and we can mirror this a variety of different ways. If we want both of our left-right parts to be in the same mesh layer, we can just do this in polygon mode. This will take just a moment because there are quite a few parts here. Oops. Now you see there's a gotcha right away. I had symmetry on, so it made kind of a screwy mess out of that, but I've turned symmetry off, so we just click in the viewport and mirror this part in polygon mode, and it'll work as expected. And so now we have landing gear that's all in one mesh item. I'm going to undo that for a moment. Alright, now you can do this in with the instance mirror tool, and it'll work the same way, except that the instance will be created in a new mesh item, but it still works as you'd expect. Now you can do this in item mode if you want to create an entirely separate item. If you're rigging, this will come in handy. So we can use the regular mirror tool, but in item mode, and what will happen is when it mirrors the part, it'll be created in a new item layer with a different label. So far, all this is working exactly as we would expect, I think. Here's one of the catches. If you have designed a whimsical object and you import some mesh item like this that you've saved, it might not be the right scale. So you might decide, okay, I want to make that a little bit bigger. Let's increase the scale here up to 120%. Now let's try some of the same operations. Alright, so we've increased the scale a little bit. We've got our action center set to origin. So let's use the mirror tool. This is in polygon mode, so the duplicate will be in the same mesh item. Okay. Again, it works as we would expect. So let's try that in item mode now. We're going to do the same thing, except we want to put this into a separate mesh layer. Now, if we look at this from the front view, we can see we have a problem. Although polygon mode seemed to work okay, if we use item mode, the mirror function is not respecting this new scale that we have on the part. In other words, it's mirroring it at the old scale of 100%, where our new part is actually 120%. And if you were looking at this from a certain viewpoint, you might just interpret that as convergence. You might not even notice it. And so let me undo that and show you something else here. This also is true with the instance mirror tool. If we instance mirror this, again, it's not respecting the new scale. So the easiest way to get around this, to avoid all sorts of hassles, is to freeze the scale of our object, and I'll show you that in a moment. But there are a couple of workarounds. For example, let's use the regular mirror tool here in item mode. All right, so there we have our new part, and it's the wrong scale. So if you click on it and go over here, you can see actually it says 100%, so that makes it pretty easy to just adjust those values manually, and now everything's fine again. Now you can also, let me undo that. You can also simply duplicate this part. Forget about the mirror function, just duplicate it in place. Okay, so now I've selected the new part, and we can adjust two numbers here to make this work for our purposes. The first one is that in position X, whatever that number is, we just want to place a minus in front of it. That'll move it over to the other side, but now you can see it's not mirrored. We can fix that by going to the scale X box here and putting a minus in front of that, and now again everything is fine. So the quickest way to avoid all these things entirely is before you start using the mirror function or trying to duplicate and change those values, just go to your item here and freeze the scale so it's 100% at whatever new values you have set. Then any of these functions here, including instance mirror, will work as you'd expect. So that's just a couple of quick gotchas there on the mirror function.